It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hey guys, Tyler here. More recently, Kansas Owens posted a clip on social media where one of her guests claims that it's easier to be gay than conservative.
Rob Smith, welcome to the Candace Owens Show. Which has been harder, coming out as gay or coming out as conservative?
Coming out as conservative has been harder, Candace. And I'll tell you why. When I came out as gay, the mom stuff notwithstanding, because, you know, we worked through that. I didn't lose friends when I came out as gay. I didn't have people that were coworkers telling me, like, all that stuff. I have lost acquaintances and so many friends that I thought were decent friends because I came out as conservative. I've had people tell me that I have a mental illness. I have people tell me that I'm being used as a tool for white supremacy. I hate myself. I hate gay people. I'm transphobic. I'm alt-right. I'm a white supremacist. I'm a Nazi. I'm all of these crazy things. And it has not been easy. Like, it's been really difficult. And when you come out as gay, people are like, congratulations. You know, nowadays,
we love you
right. For being your authentic self. But now that I'm out as conservative, it's like, oh, you're just doing this for attention, or you're just doing this for money, you're doing this whatever. Like, do you really want to get the kind of attention that I get? Because 90% of that attention is not positive.
That's what I say to people. You know? And I've made, actually, my very first YouTube video was coming out as conservative.
Yeah.
And it was sort of a satirical stab. And I was basically saying that coming out as a black conservative today is a bit like coming out as gay in the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
Before I begin my response, I first want to state that I have no problem if a person who is gay, lesbian, transgender, or bisexual has different political views than I do. I believe that people who are gay, lesbian, transgender, and bisexual are their own people, which means that they have their own personal belief systems enshrined into them. And so I think that they have the free choice to be whatever they want to be. And just because they think differently does not mean that they're a coon, an Uncle Tom, or whatever kind of slur that a person has against that person. I also want to state that I cannot disprove a negative. Basically, this guy in the clip is going off his personal experiences based upon him being a conservative and a gay person. And so basically, I cannot disprove how he felt or how he experienced things in his point of view. However, I can give examples on how it's easier for a person to be conservative than gay, objectively speaking. The first thing I want to say is that gay people across the globe face the fear of death. If a gay person, for example, comes out in an Islamic country, they will face death upon coming out because in many parts of the world, being homosexual is illegal. Conservatives, on the other hand, do not have entire holy books that say kill gay people or kill conservatives. And also, if they were to come out as conservative in any part of the world, they also do not face the fear of death at all. For the case of Christianity, depending on the denomination, if a person, for example, was more fundamentalist, they'll use the Bible, such as stories like Sodom and Gomorrah, to justify their hatred against gay people to kick them out in Bible Belt states. On the issue of adoption, there are many places that outright refuse gay people to adopt kids, whereas conservatives, on the other hand, are not refused this kind of service. Another example is the issue of marriage. Basically, in other parts of the world where homosexuality is illegal, gay people are not allowed to get married, whereas people who are conservative, people who are not gay, are allowed to get married. Thanks to the actions of Donald Trump, his administration was allowed to make sure to ban trans people from serving in the military, whereas people who are conservative, people who are not gay, are still able to serve in the military. My main point is basically this. Conservatives do not face discrimination based upon marriage, based upon military, based upon religion, based upon the idea that you cannot adopt kids if you're a certain way. Basically, there's a lot of things that are going against gay people from a much more structural standpoint than, say, conservative is for having a political belief. Look, what happened to Milo Yiannopoulos at Berkeley was not okay. The stigma of being conservative in a liberal campus is also not okay. However, let's be clear, conservatives do not have to face any sort of structural institutional discrimination, whereas basically gay people do face a lot of persecution and do face a lot of discrimination based upon the system, based upon not getting married, adopting kids, as well as to, of course, you know, die because they're gay and getting kicked out and other kind of things like that. So it's safe to say that basically they're not comparable, not in the slightest. I also find it very strange how Candace Owens basically says that she's against people who play the victim, yet here she is playing the victim for being conservative. Another form of hypocrisy from Candace Owens is how she basically says that she hates being called Uncle Tom and Coon, yet she tells people who are black who are Democrats they're part of the Democratic plantation. It is so strange. Anyway, that's my 2 cents on this clip. What do you guys think? And until next time, take care.